sky.
Please tell us why
you had to hide away for so long.
Where did we go wrong?
Enough montaging. Let's get to shopping. I did it! I escaped! Hello, Internet! This is Olin from What I'm Listening To. It's a glorious day today. It's Record Store Day. This is the day to go to your local record store, buy whatever you can, and support them, keeping records, CDs, tapes, whatever, physical media in general, alive and well and thriving. I have literally just got back from Amoeba with a huge bag full of goodies. This bag, courtesy of Amoeba. Sorry, Ellen, for not using the bag you made me here, but they insisted. But it's still a good-looking bag, regardless. I have a bunch of great things to show off today. I'm in my car because as soon as I'm done filming this, I have to go to work, unfortunately, but thank God Amoeba opened super early so I could stop in and get whatever I could. Also, if the audio sounds really shitty in this video, I apologize, I didn't bring my mic, so I'm relying heavily on my camera's built-in mic for this. At least the lighting looks good. I look gorgeous. But with all that being said, let's dive into what I got, and I'm sure people will be giving me interesting looks when they walk by and see that I'm filming in my car, but fuck them. This is a good day. I'm excited about this. I got a mixture of some exclusives for Record Store Day, as well as just some stuff that I wanted to have, just to have in my collection. So we're gonna start with those guys, the ones I just wanted. So the first thing I have for you today, I have Can's Future Days. I have been in a huge Can kick lately. I recently re-listened to their song Vitamin C, which is one of my favorite songs of theirs, also probably their most popular song. And that in turn made me go and re-listen to the album with the name I can't pronounce, Iggy something or other. And because of that, I went out and got their album Tego Mego because everybody, the internet mostly, said that that was the next album you should go listen to if you liked that kind of style of music. But what I also noticed was fans of the band say that if you liked the ambient sounding songs, you should check out this album. Needless to say, I am an ambient fan, and now that I've satisfied that craving for funk music, I can now move on to the other spectrum, so I grabbed this album. In the trio of albums that feature the vocalist Damo Suzuki, this is his last appearance, and I'm excited to check it out because I love his vocal contributions. I have the other two albums of his, so I can complete the trifecta with now getting this one. I have no idea what to expect. All I know is it's very ambient and psychedelic sounding, but if it's Can, it'll be a fantastic listen. Very happy to have found this in store. Next album I have here, I have Creedence Clearwater's Chronicle Volume 1.
Just got home from Illinois, locked the front door, oh boy. Got to sit down, take a rest on the porch. Imagination sets in, pretty soon I'm singing. Looking out my back door.
Kind of a random selection to get, but the other day I realized I don't have any Creedence in my CD collection at all. My parents have a copy of this album, and they're responsible for me having it on my iPod. but now that I don't live at home anymore, I don't have the easiest access to the CD, so I had to go pick up my own copy. This is a compilation of 20 of the band's songs. Really, really good songs. When I look through this track list, I realize how amazing they were and how many phenomenal songs they made. Suzy Q, Bad Moon Rising, Fortunate Son, that one's probably my favorite. Who Will Stop the Rain, Up Around the Bend, Run Through the Jungle, Have You Seen the Rain, Heard It Through the Grapevine. There's just tons of great stuff on here. This is one of those albums you can just put on at any point in time, whether you're relaxing, going on a drive, have people over, whatever. It's easy listening to. Most everybody likes this band, and it's just great. I'm happy to now have this in my collection. I'll probably be listening to this one on my drive over to work, because just listing those songs, I really want to listen to them. The next album in the bag, I have Gun Club's Fire of Love. I'm looking up at God to see what are you gonna do? I'm looking up and crying because I thought it was up to you. She's like heroin to me. She's like heroin to me. She's like heroin to me. She cannot miss a vein. This is an album I've known about for a very, very long time now, and I got into it actually because of the White Stripes. Back when I think I was in junior college, maybe even when I was a senior in high school, I got into a bit of a White Stripes kick, having only really known a couple of their songs, and I explored their albums and I picked up a few of them, and the one that struck me the most was their second album, Distill. That particular record is way, way more blues-oriented than any of the stuff they do. And for me, it's my favorite in their discography. I love the combination of traditional-sounding blues music with the slide guitar, all that jazz, as well as the heavy, abrasive elements of punk rock. So after listening to that album over and over and over again, I was left wanting more punk blues music. So I went on the internet and looked for punk blues albums and found this one. While this one might be a much earlier release than the White Stripes stuff, it's still a pretty legendary record, especially in the sense of punk and blues. I think on here, yeah, 1981 is when this one came out. But it has some absolutely phenomenal songs on here. I think Sex Beat might be my favorite. It's the first track on the CD. But songs like Preaching the Blues, Cool Drink of Water, Goodbye Johnny, it's just phenomenal. And it took me until right now to finally own a physical edition of it, partially because I could never find it in store, but Amoeba just so happened to have one today, so figured it would be a perfect time to get it on record store day. But they creep for what they need, and they explode to the car, and then they move. Okay, moving on to the new stuff here. The first of the new stuff I have isn't necessarily a Record Store Day exclusive, but it may as well be, and I'll explain in a minute. This is Finesse's new album, Agora. Like I said, this technically isn't a Record Store Day exclusive. This came out, I think, sometime last week. I went into Amoeba, I believe, on the day it came out, and they didn't have a copy in store, which I found to be kind of a bummer. So the days leading on, I would pop into Amoeba just to see if they maybe got it in, which, unfortunately, they didn't. I finally had to ask an employee when they were gonna get it in. He didn't even really know and said at some point. So instead of constantly going in to see whether or not they had it, I decided, let's wait until Record Store Day to pick it up. And now I got it. Finesse is now one of my new favorite experimental musicians out there. He has a lot of stuff in his discography, some of which that I haven't actually listened to, but the stuff I have listened to, I absolutely love. His album Endless Summer is one of the best glitchy ambient albums I've ever heard, and then his first album, which he collaborates with Ryuichi Sakamoto, is gorgeous. I was lucky enough to find a copy of that one in store, which is great because it's so rare. Still looking for the other album that they put out together, but I digress. This album, brand spanking new, had no idea that Finesse was even releasing new music until I found out about it last week. This album, only 4 songs long, but I think each song is about 15 to 20 minutes long, which is so typical for experimental musicians. I heard a clip of his song Rainfall and found it absolutely beautiful. The part of the song I sampled sounded a little less glitch-oriented and more so on the ambient side of things, but regardless of what style he does, it's great. It's Finesse. Very excited to have this in my collection now and pop it open and give the full thing a listen. Okay, now let's get to the Record Store Day exclusive that I got. I only got 2 things because I bought everything else here and I figured I shouldn't go overboard, but I got some things regardless. And the first thing of that is Sun's brand new record. Sun might have been the first drone metal band I'd ever heard. I can't remember if I found them first or Earth. I'm pretty sure I found them first. But I discovered their album Black One, which is probably their most famous album, and it's fantastic. At the time when I heard it, I found it to be pretty cool, but I still really wasn't too crazy about drone music, so I found some parts of it to be really weird, but other parts of it really, really awesome. That wasn't until I really got into experimental music to where I could fully appreciate the album and the people involved in it. There's a lot of great musicians who are involved with the making of that. But like that Finesse album, when I saw that the band announced the release of this, I was really, really, really excited. The selling point for me with this album is that Steve Albini from Big Black is the producer behind the record. For me, anything that guy touches is amazing. He has a certain way of mixing stuff to where it sounds really, really great. Considering that he's involved with this weird legendary drone metal band, I couldn't pass it up. I had to go check it out. I have no idea what any of this sounds like. I kind of did that on purpose because I didn't want to ruin anything for me, but I like the band enough. I'm sure this is fantastic. They've had some solid releases over the year, so I'm looking forward to listening to this one in its entirety. Again, it's only 4 songs long, but I'm certain they're like 20 minutes apiece, so it'll be a really, really cool, scary experience to listen to this. Alright, internets, the last thing I have for you today, this is the only record I got. In fact, this is the first piece of vinyl I've purchased in a really, really long time. I have Jeff Tweedy's Warmer. Last year, Jeff released his very first solo album entitled Warm. And if you saw my top 10 2018 video, you'll see that I placed it as number 3 on the list because I loved it so very much. But any of you who know me will know that I'm a huge, huge Wilco fan, and in turn, a huge Jeff Tweedy fan. So basically anything that Wilco or Jeff Tweedy will put out, I will instantly grab. When the Record Store Day website announced their full list of exclusive releases, I saw that Jeff had put out this, And as soon as I saw it, I had to go research it and see what the hell it was. So what Warmer is 10 songs that were recorded during the Warm sessions and were never actually put out until now. So this guy has 10 songs that didn't make the final cut of Warm, but Jeff still had the foresight to release it to the public on Record Store Day, which is absolutely perfect. I think he released a music video for one of these songs, Family Ghost, yeah. But I didn't listen to it. Again, I didn't want to ruin it. I wanted to listen to the album in its entirety when I got the record, and now I have it here. I kind of hope that he'll release this on CD maybe after the Record Store Day hype goes away. We'll have to see. If it stays a vinyl exclusive, that's fine, because I have my copy here. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to wait till tonight to listen to this because I have to go to work right after this, which is a bummer, but oh well. So Jeff, if you're out there and you're watching this for some reason, thank you so much for releasing more music. I love everything that you do. So this is gonna be an excellent addition to my collection here, and I just might actually hang this up on my wall when I'm done listening to it. The cover is really, really cool. I can have Jeff just staring down at me while I sleep. That's not creepy at all.
I'm a man content for the sake of argument. Underneath each shattered straw, oh, I feel so American.
Alrighty then, Internet, that does it for me. Hey, if you went to Record Store Day and got some cool stuff, leave a comment down below. Tell me what you got. Tell me what's worth checking out. There was a lot of stuff that came out that I just didn't look into. Also, if you like this video, be sure to hit that subscribe button. It'll show me the support and I'll love your face for it. And you can also follow me on Instagram for even more music. I post a new album every single day, talk a little bit about it, and it gives you a bit of an insight of what else is in my collection. So, thank you all very, very much for watching this video. Now go out there and go shop for music. Go support your local record stores. Keep vinyl, keep CD, keep tapes, keep physical media alive. It's something that nerds like me love. I love going to record stores. I would hate to see them die out. They're just so much fun and they just bring me so much happiness. This is one of my favorite days of the year, so please, 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 go support your local record store. Get something. I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye, Internet.